those of you who are coming from overseas, thank you for honoring us with your presence in participating in this very important media symposium. So we have hundreds of thousands of displaced people today in Syria, Iraq, hundreds of thousands flocking to Europe. They bring extraordinary social political pressure to these countries, and that in turn causes extremism on the part of the receiving countries, contribute to rising nationalism, racism, and violence. In the midst of all of this, what is the role of journalists? What is the role of the social media? Well, what we witness is that democratic countries like France and others, Germany, are talking about controlling social media. Because unfortunately, one technology that may be available to you, to the dear friends, brothers and sisters, sitting in this conference room, listening to me, may be available to you, these tools, for what is objective, honest, impartial, neutral supply of information to the public. Well, the same technology can be used by anyone, by individuals, by group of individuals, for very complete purpose, to instigate violence. Remember, the genocide in Rwanda in 1994, it was made possible partly through the use of radio communication, radio, the old radio that we used to play music, we used to read out news about developments in the country, in a village, in a town. Well, was used by extremist elements in Rwanda to instigate racial, ethnic hatred. And very quickly, violence spread like wildfire. Close to 1 million people were slaughtered in less than 1 year, in 8 months. In the Balkans, during the Bosnia, Kosovo, and Croatia war, again, it was the same tool, radio, television, available to anyone, to professional media, was available to the dictator Milosevic to instigate anti-Muslim, anti-Bosnian, anti-Kosovar sentiment and led to the genocide in Bosnia. And we can see the situation like in Myanmar and elsewhere. The role of individuals, ultra-nationalists, religious leaders, Buddhist leaders, instigating hatred towards Muslims, towards the ethnic minority called Rohingya. So how can we regulate the use of social media? Easy to regulate with respect to absolute freedom of expression of thought by with professional journalists. Professional journalists, they know what is their responsibility, their role is. They are visible, they are there, they have an office. You have an office, you have a salary, or at least some of you, or most of you have a salary. So, yeah. But how about those who are not professional journalists, who are actually professional agitators, who under the cover of social media, all they do is to disseminate false information with a political purpose, to denigrate political leaders who are elected, to instigate violence, religious, ethnic violence, in order to bring down an elected government that they don't like because it doesn't conform to their vision of the country or of the world. So that is where it is extraordinarily the extraordinary challenge, the difficulty in establishing the limits of freedom in now in 21st century media environment with 21st century technology, and at the same time protect the privacy, the honor, the integrity of individuals. Relatively easy for the mainstream media. And the mainstream media today is not only the print media, not only the TV channels that we know about, not only the radio. The mainstream media, also the online media. But the online media, well, I as an individual, I can do my online media. I don't need now a big company. I don't need a wealthy investor. I can do it. And I alone as an individual, I can disrupt, I can cause havoc in a society, in a community. And what are my responsibilities? What are the laws that protect others against my action? And how can we, in trying to protect privacy, trying to protect the right of the society to live in peace, but at the same time we don't infringe on freedom of expression? Because some governments, we know, in many countries, now they are using the violence perpetrated by some in social media to completely dominate, control, ban social media. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, these are my simple reflections, concerns. I did not prepare, as you can see, I just talk as if I'm with you, sharing a platform, my concern. In regard to Timor-Leste, to end, well, I'm very pleased to still live in a free, democratic country. My observation, I'm not a member of government, I'm not a political leader, I don't have any political party affiliation, I don't have a job with the president, the parliament, or the government, I'm completely free. And I'm able to distance myself both from the government, from the state, as well as distance myself from the media. Because the media, even in a free a country like Timor, or like in Australia, like in throughout the world, they have a biases. Important is that the government, political leaders, do not try to intimidate journalists. I'm totally against it as a matter of principle, but not only as a matter of principle, even common sense. We are a very free country. And I always tell some of my compatriots in politics, you try to put pressure on a journalist, he or she will do even worse. So you put pressure, you threaten him or her, today, tomorrow it will be front page. They even will exaggerate. So better don't say anything, don't do anything. Let them do whatever they feel like, and you have the right to respond. And today, I as an individual, I have a much more possibility to respond. I don't need to waste my time to write a letter to the editor. Because in the past, you recall, you write a letter to the editor, yes, usually they publish, but they edit. You one page, they cut it down to half page. They say, oh, reasons of space. Well, now I don't even bother. I use my Facebook page to respond. And then it goes everywhere. So that is also the positive side of 21st century technology, 21st century social media. I thank you all, and God bless you, and I hope those of you who visit us, besides working, try to visit the city, at least visit the country, so that you go back to the region and share with your viewers, your listeners, your readers, the great positive developments of this country that has the best functioning democracy in Southeast Asia, the freest media in Southeast Asia. And in only 15 years since independence, of beginning with absolute zero, complete destruction in 99, with very little money in 2002. Look at the physical transformation of the country. Look at the people. That is the progress we have made in the last 17 years since independence.